Belvedere West famously said, "Don't be afraid of the space between your dreams and the reality. If you can dream, you can make it." I welcome back all the attendees to the fifth day of IEEE Entrepreneurship Bootcamp.
Let's start with today's last session, Fireside with Aparna Mishra, mental health practitioner. Our speaker is a multidimensional person, business coach, qualified with 28 years of experience in corporate, excellent communicator, great networker, skilled in mentoring and managing teams, a science graduate, management professional with strong ability to solve complex business problems using on-ground experience. I welcome you, ma'am. I request ma'am to take further the event.
Thank you so much, Raj and Shreya, and thank you, Mr. Dinesh, for giving me an opportunity to speak to students, which I really enjoy talking to them all the time, because then because you're so raw, you know, so I can at least share that thing with you, and then accordingly you can mold yourself according to situations, basically. So thank you for my introduction, Raj. Yes, I am a business coach, and first of all, I would like to tell you from where I belong to, because I guess people watching here really don't know from where I am. I'm from Lucknow. Have you heard of name Mr. Yogi? Of course, suna hoga, Chief Minister,
yes,
Mr.
Yogi. Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Usi state ki hu, and usi capital city, Lucknow is the capital of Uttar Pradesh, and I'm from that state only, correct? I think now you can relate where is Lucknow, correct?
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Coming back to the entrepreneurship journey, you know, since you all are, you'll be completing your courses and then you'll be thinking of starting your own businesses, correct? So I think this is a time wherein you need to be really sure what action you would like to take. And also, if even if you're taking some action, whether this is viable, whether this is correct, whether this is wrong, correct? You know, sometimes you will be in two minds, isko kare ki na kare, ye bhi hota hai. So now things, it's like this, you know, like if I talk about my journey, I started way back in after completing, because since I'm from Lucknow, I have done everything in Lucknow, all these studies, my businesses, everything in Lucknow. Because, you know, agar aap kisi tier 2 city se ho, and even if I talk about 1990s, right? Most of them, you must have not even born by that time. So usme kya hota tha? Us samay, there was no internet, no LinkedIn, no Facebook, nothing was there. So, you know, we had a very simple lifestyle, you know, but since I'm not from a family business background. So, you know, my father, he got retired from a government job. So usme kya hota tha? 10th kiya, 12th kiya, graduation kiya, MBA kiya, ya kuch aur kiya, and then जॉब किया, राइट? दिस वाज स्ट्रेट 1 2 3 4 स्टेप्स. अब क्या हो गया है, सो मेनी स्टेप्स इन बिटवीन एज वेल. पहले कोई ऐसा कुछ नहीं था. सो सिमिलरली आई फॉलोड ऑल द स्टेप्स 1 2 3 4 एंड आई डिड माय एमबीए, डिड माय एवरीथिंग आई डिड इन लखनऊ. सिंस आई वाज द एल्डर वन इन द सिब्लिंग्स, सो माय डैड वाज डेड स्केयर्ड ऑफ सेंडिंग मी आउट. अब क्या होता है, अब तो वी वांट टू गो आउट एंड स्टडी, राइट? मे बी सम इंटरनेशनल और कहीं पे भी स्टेट में. उस समय तो इतना, यू नो, दे वर सो स्केयर्ड कि कहाँ भेजेंगे, क्या भेजेंगे, ऑल सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग्स. सो आई डिड माय ग्रेजुएशन इन लखनऊ, एमबीए इन लखनऊ, देन स्टार्टेड माय जॉब इन लखनऊ, एंड थैंकफुली बाय द गॉड्स ग्रेस टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया वाज इन लखनऊ. सो देयर वाज दिस, वंस आई फिनिश्ड माय एमबीए, देयर वाज दिस एड ऑन एसेंट, यू नो, रिक्रूटमेंट Times of India, SN page, there was this ad for Times of India. They were looking for trainees. So I quickly applied in that. And thankfully, I got my call, interview letter, interview call, and then I joined TOI. So I joined in 1990, 1st January 1990, very important day for me. So, us samay 1990 mein, you can imagine kya companies honge Lucknow mein, right? There were hardly, even Hindustan Times bhi nahi tha tab Lucknow mein, us samay ki baat hai. So there were very few organizations in Lucknow. So I was confined to one good organization where I was working. Though it was, and you'd not believe, I think aajkal ke time mein bahut kam log itna karte honge. I was there for 12 years. Can you imagine in current situation, aap kisi company mein 12 saal kaam karo? I don't think so. But us samay I worked because there were hardly any companies in Lucknow. So we had no option. Then my dad said, "Isse achhi company kya milegi?" So I continued. though I worked for 2 years in Times of India Delhi as well, because due to family reasons, I had to take a transfer. Then again, I came back. But these 12 years, you know, although sunne mein lagta hai 12 saal kaise kaam kiya, but you know, 12 saal, they were foundation of me, what I'm today, you know. 2 years was in Delhi Times of India. That totally transformed me, because I was very extrovert, being from a tier 2 city, you know, Lucknow, small town. Ab to nahi hai small town, tab small town tha. So very, you know, extrovert, not even wanted to meet people, apne you confined to your work, all these things. But Delhi has really changed me a lot. So I really give thanks to Times of Delhi for changing me totally. So once I came back from Delhi, then it was too much of TOI, you know. So then, and then that point of time, there were companies in Lucknow as well. So I shifted to Modi Revlon, which is a cosmetic company. The girls would know over here. I was into Revlon. I was a franchise manager. I was setting up franchises, and we were traveling MP, Chhattisgarh, UP, and all these things. We were doing that. After that, there were certain health problems or because of traveling too much. So again, I shifted and I joined the Reliance Communication. That was a good odd 5-6 years I was there. So if you combine, it's 18 years of corporate experience, but 18 years really added to my profile. You know, it was good brands, Times of India, Revlon, Reliance Communication. What else one could ask for? So three good brands I had worked with. Then in 18 years, I got so much of, you know, confidence, so much of knowledge, so much of my change in personality that helped me in my entrepreneurship journey. You know, when we were working in Times of India or even with Reliance, we were able to do 3-4 things at the same time. This has helped made me a good multitasker. Normally people say it's not good to be a multitasker. But sometimes I think if you take my case, it's good to be a multitasker in my case only. It depends upon individuals, right? I can do so many things at the same time because I've been conditioned like that in all my organizations in 18 years. So I know, therefore I can prioritize my things. I can feel, okay, this is important. You know, there's a quadrant example where you put in very important, not important, most important, urgent. So I always put my things into those quadrants and then I pick up things and do it. This is the way I do things. So I think thanks to my organization, which have really gave me things. And I think that confidence gave me chance to venture into something of my own. Because, you know, kehte nahi hai ki entrepreneur, you know, you're never born with an entrepreneur mindset. Things change. You evolve with the things happening around you. And then you think, okay, I have to do this. Since I was not from a business background, so hota kya, if you are from a business background, you're deemed normally it is ki aap, you'll just continue the business with them only, you know. But I was not from a business background, so I have to dig my own things and start on my own. So there was no support from my family that, okay, father hai business mein, chalo paisa laga do, ye kar do, franchise, aisa kuch bhi nahi tha. Whatever I did, even if I took a franchise, it was all from my saved money from my corporates, which I took a franchise. So I'm proud to say that I'm a self-made person. And you know, when I started this venture, so it was like, because since it was at that 18 years, things have changed, Lucknow has changed, internet was there, LinkedIn was there, so much of change happened. So then, you know, you started realizing, okay. And also I would like to tell you, when I was working with Times of India, since whenever we had some free time, we used to read this Economic Times, which we were getting in Times of India, you know. So we used to read, I used to read the stories of people, of industrialists and all these things. So I wanted, yeah, maybe even I want to do something like this, but how? Because again, of no background, nothing, no. And then I had never that business bent of mine. Wo aaj bhi nahi hai, but still I am doing things. So then I was thinking what to do. And this what to do, what karte karte, you know, 18 years ho gaye mujhe ki kya karun, kya karun. Hote hote, then I thought, and you know, when I left my job, my age was 40. So at the age of 40, if you want to leave something, it's so risky, you know, you're at some level, senior level, good salary, everything is, life is settled almost. And then suddenly you want to leave everything and start something from zero. So again, I left, but I had made up of my made up this mind that I have to start something of my own. So I quit and I took a franchise of a company with my saved money. I gave that franchise fees. I started off. Then again, after 2 years, the franchise was closed down. So now my journey started off bumps on the road, right? The entrepreneurship road is not a straight line. It is always ups and down, the roller coaster journey. So if any of you, I think many of you must be thinking of starting a business, you need to be ready. See, I'm here not to discourage you, but to enlighten you that what is the world, you know, grass is always greener on the other side. But when you go there, then you realize it's not, you're not repenting what you have done. But then if you are aware of all the circumstances which will come, then it's better that you are readily, you are prepared, you can prepare yourself for all these things which are coming, right? So yeah, franchise was closed down because of some problem at the management level. But then again, whatever I did, if I talk about my journey, 18 years, I was into sales, I was into marketing. Marketing, you'll say it was a Revlon, which I did all these stores and all, no marketing campaigns. Then operation, customer handling, I was into customer handling in Reliance as well, as in Times of India also. So these were the areas I was groomed in these organizations. When this entrepreneurship journey started, you know, I did cold calls also. So, you know, when you start something of your own, then 18 years becomes zero. You know, you have to again start from scratch. So I used to go to various organizations, Lucknow only, and started doing cold calls of various things. And it helped. Sometimes I was asked to wait for so many hours, which I was not even used to, but then I had to do it. Because I had chosen my life, which is not a corporate life, an entrepreneurial journey. It was my life, which I've chosen it. So I have to be with that. Whatever, even if it is a wrong decision or a right decision, I have to be with that, whatever decision I took, right? So slowly, my things got started. Then I started a call center that also went off. You know, there was a major fire in my call center. So if you see my life, it is not a straight line. There's never a straight line, you know. Always something or other is happening in my life. But then that has made me stronger. You know, the person I was in 2008 when I left my job, and the person in 2021 is totally different. The 360 degrees change in myself, my mentality, my thinking, my personality, my confidence. Everything has changed, and my attitude as well. So these things, you know, you learn to do these things when you are into some problem or something like that. So when my call center was, there was a fire, but again, I started again, but then I was told that we need to close the center because they had got this letter from their head office, then they will not outsource this call center. So it was closed down. This was a major blow to my business. You know, I was earning so good. It was 5-6 years I continued this call center. And I was flying high, you know, you can say that. It was the upward climb for me. The moment this call center was closed down or even the fire was there, I quickly slid down. And it was a major dent in my life, in my, everything, all phases of my life is a major dent in my life. So if I talk about your thing, since now you will be going out to be thinking of your business. So first of all, you need to see that. Not every person can start the business. I think this is a very crude sentence, but it is very true. Har ek jana startup nahi ho sakta. Har ek jana entrepreneur nahi ho sakta. You need to have those qualities first. If you think, no, I can be, I'm a risk taker, I'm a confident person. It is never like that. Jaise har idea achha nahi hota hai, aise hi har business successful nahi hota hai, and har student ek entrepreneur nahi ho jata hai. So these are very crude things, but these are very true. So you need to identify your strengths. Am I good enough to take risk? Do I have those qualities in me that I can start my business? Like if I talk about myself, since I have been 18 years, 11 years, and into this whole 29 years, if you talk about, I was totally doing sales. I was doing strategy, strategizing my business. I was into operations because I have worked with those organizations. I have handled a call center. for so long, then, and of course, strategy and sales. Sales, I was into sales in Revlon as well. I was into sales into Triumphs of India as well. Because after, when you work for 12 years in an organization, you see all the departments. It is not just one department, you know. So I was into sales as well. So with all these four, if I talk about my strengths, these are my strengths. So if I want to start something, I will work in these four areas only, correct? Suppose I'm a I have done my MBA in sales and I want to start an HR company, I will not do it. I will not be able to be successful in that because I have not that HR bent of mine. I have not even done anything in HR. I don't know how HR works, correct? Unless until you collaborate with someone who's into HR and you are into sales, then it's a very good combination. That person will do HR. You can go and get clients, onboard your clients. So that is a good combination. But if you're just a pure salesperson, if you really want to do an HR, then it will not be successful because you don't have that bent of mind. Now, so you need to really work on your strengths, identify, because I cannot identify your strength. You're the best person who can judge, okay, what I'm good at. Am I a tech person? If I'm a tech person, then I can be good at creating apps, software, something like that, right? But if I'm a salesperson, I'm good at selling things, selling concepts, selling products. I'm good at that things. So you need to really combine. You can, 3-4 people can combine all the strengths and start a company. That is also possible. So this is something very important that you need to identify your strength. If you're not good at some work, outsource that work or collaborate your work. So that is the, I think that's the anthem of today, that you need to collaborate more. You need to outsource things more rather than doing everything on your own. You can't do everything in your business because there are so many facets in a business, correct? Also, you need to, if you want to start something, my advice is there to every student, that if you want to start a business, you need to, again, you come back to your strengths, right? If you want to start an e-commerce company, you should take some internship in that company, or maybe you work in some e-commerce company for a few years, maybe 2 years or 3 years. You learn the nuances of business first, right? Because if you're starting something which you have never done before, how do you know whether this is, whatever you're doing, what all things are involved into a business, how is logistics handled, how is onboarding happens? You don't know anything. So when you work in some organization, you get to learn everything of a business. And now then, after 2 or 3 years, then you can evaluate whether you want to continue in that organization, or maybe go to some other organization for work, or you want to start your own business in that particular sector, correct? You might also change the thought. You said, okay, no, e-commerce is not good. I think I should start something else. So these things happen after 2 or 3 years when you are capable enough to analyze yourself, what are my strengths are. So this is something very important for any business. Now comes, let's imagine, okay, you have already got few people wherein you are starting your own business. You have already done everything, got a company registered and all. Then how do you market it? That is also very important. You need to be thoroughly, aware of how to market your products. And also in a startup, when you start your businesses, like, I think one thing is very important, which is networking. You know, when I was working, see, when you work, no, one thing is very good, that you get your paycheck on 30th of the month or 1st of the month, right? But when you are on your own, you don't get paychecks. You really wait for the paychecks. Okay, I'll get order from this client first, then we'll have a salary. Sometimes 2-3 months, you don't even take salary from your business. Because you need to put that money into business, right? Whereas in a job, you really get your paychecks every month. So, but then you don't have flexibility there. You can't even do things of what you like to do, right? And then also, if I talk about internship of some organization, if you want to do some internship also, don't go into big corporates, right? Because if you go into a corporate, you're confined to one department only. But if you're going to a startup to get internship, you're confined to all the departments. That would tell you how you're able to run the business, you know? So if you want to start a business, take an internship with a startup. There you learn, sales, you learn accounts, you learn hiring, you learn marketing, you learn how to manage teams, you learn operations, everything you will learn. But if you go to a big corporate, then you can't learn anything. So again, coming back to my paycheck thing, you know, when you get a paycheck, you're just confined to 9 to 5 or 10 to 6 job. You don't have any time to even network with people, right? Only Saturday, Sunday is off, or even sometimes these days also, now since it's a work from home these days, every all 7 days working, you know, so it's better. So when I was working, I was not, there are so many associations, you know, again, I'll just come back to that thing again. So the moment I left my job in 2008, first thing what I did, I became member of so many associations in Lucknow. Like in Mumbai, you have Mumbai Management Association, right? You have CII, you have PhD, you have FICCI, and XYZ, so many associations, business associations, basically. So the moment I left my job, I took membership of all these associations in my city. Then I started moving out, though my venture was there, but whenever they had meetings, you know, I used to go out, meet people. So networking is essential, utmost important for any startup to start into business, right? It will add to your business. It may not add immediately, but maybe after a few months or after a few years, you never know, you meet somebody and that person can give you order, or maybe after a few years or few months, you never know that. So I used to go there, attend meetings, meet people, tell them what I'm doing and all. And I started getting good response out of it because I started trainings, you know, corporate trainings. I was getting orders from corporates. I used to go there and conduct trainings, or maybe hire a trainer and conduct trainings over there. So that was the best thing which I did. And still, I am into networking so much that I think, and since now LinkedIn is there, first of all, you must create a profile on LinkedIn. Even if you're a student, if you're not, even if you're working, even if you're a startup, you should have a profile on LinkedIn, which is something very important. And then start adding people in your network, start meeting. And first of all, where you are, from which city you are, you should become member of few organizations wherever you can afford to join the memberships. So that when you meet people, you know, there's so much of change which happens. Agar aap kisi se milte ho, aap interact karte ho, unse baat karte ho, kuch aap seekhte ho, kuch wo aapse seekhte hain. And then whatever you absorb from them, apply that in your life, in your business as well. So it is very important. Kabhi kabhi kya hota hai, kuch startups hain jo, I've seen that they are just confined to their work. They even don't socialize, they even don't network, though they are on LinkedIn, but usse kuch nahi hota hai. Aapko networking to karni hi padegi, because that is the thing which will add. Aap jo apna card exchange karte ho logon se, cards log rakhte hain. जो लोग बहुत ही ज्यादा नेटवर्किंग करते हैं, यू नो, दे डोंट जस्ट कलेक्ट कार्ड्स फॉर द हेक ऑफ इट, उस पर लिख भी देते हैं कि कौन हमें कब मिला, कहाँ से मिला. तो आई थिंक वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है कि आपको नेटवर्किंग, अगर आप नहीं कर रहे हैं, प्लीज ज्वाइन सम एसोसिएशंस. CII का यंग मैनेजर्स फोरम है, यू ज्वाइन दैट, यू टेंड टू मीट सो मेनी पीपल, वो इट्स गुड इंडस्ट्रीज, कॉर्पोरेट प्रोफेशनल सब उसमें आते हैं, यू शुड मीट दोज पीपल. तो networking something very important. Then when we talk about flexibility, you know, when I'll start my own business, I'll be flexible, I can do anything whenever I like. Guys, it's not like that. Flexibility sounds very interesting. Even I thought that whenever I leave my job, ye to bahut hi tabo ho gaya schedule, I'll have my own flexible time, main kabhi bhi ja sakti hu, kabhi bhi kuch kar sakti hu. But believe me, aap apne job se zyada apne business mein kaam karte ho. For us, it's never, no Sunday, no weekends, nothing, because this is your own business. It is your own hard-earned money which you are getting. आपको लगेगा ये मेरा time waste हो रहा है. ये जब आप एक settle हो जाते हो, एक level पे आके आपको लगता है now things are settled, business is coming on your auto mode, then you start relaxing, then you start going on a weekends, going on vacation. But when you start your business, आपको लगता है ये money मेरा waste हो रहा है. इस मनी को मैं बिजनेस में लगा लूं, आई शुड गेट सम मोर एम्प्लॉइज, मैं साल ये पैसा मैं उसमें लगा दूं, यू नो, यू नीड, यू फोकस ऑन द बिजनेस फर्स्ट. सो इसीलिए तब फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी कुछ नहीं होती. यस, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ये होती है कि आप अपने अकॉर्डिंग चीजें प्रायोरिटाइज कर लेते हो, राइट, विच इज नॉट देयर इन जॉब. बट देन आप इट्स नॉट दैट कि 9 बजे से ही काम शुरू, कभी कोई कॉल आपको सुबह मिडनाइट कॉल करनी है, कभी इंटरनेशनल कॉल करनी है, यू हैव टू बी देयर, राइट? सैटरडे संडे कोई क्लाइंट से मीटिंग है, यू विल नॉट से आज तो संडे है, आज मैं नहीं काम करूंगा, आई स्पीक टू यू ऑन मंडे. इट इज नेवर लाइक दैट. इट्स ऑलवेज व्हेनेवर यू आर, एंड सिंस नाउ इट्स इज व्हाट्सएप, यू कैन इमीडिएट, कभी एनीबॉडी कैन अप्रोच यू एनी टाइम, यू कैन अप्रोच एनीबॉडी, किसी भी टाइम आप बात कर सकते हो, प्रोवाइडेड दैट पर्सन इज अवेक. सो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी आप अपने काम में कर सकते हो, बट टाइम की फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी नहीं है, इसमें आपको ज्यादा काम करना पड़ता है. बट यस, इफ यू हैव मेड अप योर माइंड कि मुझे करना है, अगर इफ यू थिंक कि मेरे में वो कैपेबिलिटीज हैं, वो स्ट्रेंथ्स हैं, मैं कर सकता हूँ, देन ऑफ कोर्स गो अहेड, डाइव डाउन. दिस इज अ वंडरफुल वर्ल्ड, यू नो, दो अप्स एंड डाउन्स है, रोड बहुत बम्पी है, बट क्या फर्क पड़ता है. इफ यू आर एबल टू ड्राइव प्रॉपरली, आपको बम्स भी नहीं पता चलेंगे कितने बम्स आए हैं, बट यू आर ड्राइविंग इट फास्ट, आपको जरूर बम्स का फील होगा कि यहाँ तो बहुत बम्पी रोड है ये. सो ये सब आपको अपने चीजों में सोचना पड़ेगा. यू रियली इवैल्यूएट योरसेल्फ. आई कैन नॉट इवैल्यूएट इंडिविजुअली, बट यस, आप अपने को इवैल्यूएट कर सकते हो कि किस तरह से आप बिजनेस कर सकते हो. एंड देन वन नीड टू बी वेरी पॉजिटिव एज वेल, बिकॉज जब बम्पी रोड होगी, रोलर कोस्टर राइड होगी, तो कभी टाइम ऐसे आएगा जब आपको लगेगा मैंने क्यों बिजनेस किया, मेरे फादर ने कहा था जॉब करो, मेरे जॉब ही अच्छा था, या मैंने जॉब छोड़ के बिजनेस क्यों किया. यू नो, ये चीजें आती हैं. अभी आप कहोगे नहीं नहीं कुछ नहीं आता है, बट आई नो आता है, आई एम गोइंग थ्रू इट, मेरे को भी होता है कभी कभी. आई वुड बी डिसऑनेस्ट इफ आई टेल यू कि मुझे बिल्कुल भी नहीं कभी होता है कि मुझे जॉब तो छोड़ना अच्छा लगा नहीं. आई फील दैट sometimes, of course, कि मैंने जॉब क्यों छोड़ा. यू नो, इज अ कम्फर्टेबल लाइफ, गुड सैलरी, गुड अच्छी सैलरी आपको मिलती है आप एक इतने साल जॉब कर रहे होते हो. सो समटाइम्स आई डू फील दैट, बिकॉज आफ्टर ऑल आई एम ऑल्सो ह्यूमन बींग, आई एम नॉट अ स्टोन, यू नो. तो मुझे भी फील होता है कि मैंने क्यों जॉब छोड़ा, वाई यार मेरे को पेरेंट्स की बात मान लेनी चाहिए थी. बट इमिडिएटली क्विक सेकेंड आई जस्ट रिलाई अगेन, मेरे दिमाग में आता है नो नो ठीक है, लेट मी जस्ट सी क्या क्या गड़बड़ हुआ है, यू नो. So whenever you are there, you meet people. Sometimes कोई deal आपकी crack होगी, कोई deal नहीं crack होगी, पैसे का loss होगा, orders नहीं मिलेंगे. You know, जैसे ये pandemic आ गया, कितने businesses affect हुए. But अगर इसी समय, अगर if you keep a positive mindset, you know, आपको लगता है कि ठीक है अभी कुछ हुआ है, कुछ time में ठीक हो जाएगा. Let's see that ways, because you know, होता क्या है, when I was working, शाम को आते थे, तो you know, I was into tension. अरे यार कल ऑफिस जाना है, अब ये काम करना है, बॉस ने ये कहा था ये करना है, that pressure was there all the time. अब क्या होता है, when I come home after work, when I go out, do conduct my meetings, come back home, I evaluate my day, you know. आपको वो दिन evaluate करना चाहिए कि आज आपके दिन में क्या क्या हुआ, कहाँ गड़बड़ हुई, ये डील हमें क्यों नहीं मिली, उन्होंने मुझे मना क्यों किया, right? या ये डील हमें मिल गई, good, अब इसको आगे कैसे करना है. Now, what is the next step on this deal? So I do that. I evaluate my day. And when I evaluate my day, I give resolution at the same time only to my mind. Ki, no, isko aise karna hai, isko aise karna hai. Okay, I'll do it this tomorrow. So then I'm thinking positive in my mind. Ki agar ye mere saath hua hai, to iska positive aspect ye hai. So I'll do this in a better way tomorrow. Iska matlab kahin mere baat mein gadbad hua hai ya... I think this, I should not approach such type of clients. My approach should be different. You need to evaluate yourself all the time because you are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. Even I'm not perfect. So, agar kahin humse kuch galat ho raha hai, koi galat humne decision le liya hai, so you need to rectify that. Zindagi nahi khatam ho jati hai. But then you need to really think on those decisions. Aapne kya decision kiya hai? Isme kya galat hua hai? Isko kaise sahi kar sakte hain? Ye aapko sochna padega. और ये तभी आप सोचोगे व्हेन यू विल हैव अ पॉजिटिव माइंडसेट, व्हिच इज सो मच इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इन अ स्टार्टअप फॉर अ पर्सन हु वांट्स टू स्टार्ट अ स्टार्टअप और हु वांट्स टू बिकम एन एंटरप्रेन्योर. पॉजिटिव माइंड नहीं होगा बिकॉज आपको इतने अप्स एंड डाउन फेस करने पड़ेंगे. अगर आप पॉजिटिव माइंड लेके ही नहीं चलोगे तो यू विल नॉट इवन क्रॉस वन बैरियर. लाइफ इज फुल ऑफ बैरियर्स. व्हाई ओनली एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, अदरवाइज लाइफ हैज सो मेनी बैरियर्स. जॉब में कितने बैरियर्स होते हैं, कभी बॉस ने आपको प्रेजल नहीं दिया, आपकी जॉब छूट गई, दूसरी की जॉब नहीं मिल रही है. लाइफ इज फुल ऑफ बैरियर्स, यू नो, इट इज नॉट जस्ट एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप जर्नी, इट्स एवरीवेयर. सो इफ यू आर एबल टू क्रॉस दोज बैरियर्स विद अ पॉजिटिव माइंड, आई एम श्योर यू विल रीच अ वेरी गुड डेस्टिनेशन ऑफ योर चॉइस विच यू हैड ड्रीम्ड ऑफ अर्लियर. सो फॉर दिस यू नीड टू बी पॉजिटिव ऑल द टाइम. कहना बहुत आसान है, आपको कह अरे मैम बहुत इट्स सो इजी टू से पॉजिटिव, बट कौन पॉजिटिव रहता है एग्जैक्टली? जब आपके साथ खराब चीज होती है तो उसमें पॉजिटिविटी नहीं आती है, नेगेटिविटी आती है. बट देन अगर आप उस नेगेटिविटी को प्रोलोंग करोगे तो पॉजिटिविटी नहीं आ पाएगी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल जब मेरे कॉल सेंटर में आग लगी, तो मेजर फायर, तो क्या हुआ? उससे पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड हम मैं नहीं रख सकती थी ना. मेरे को चला अरे क्या हो गया, तो सब जल गया. क्विकली मेरे दिमाग में क्या आया कि ओ माई गॉड, माई इन्वेस्टमेंट हैज गॉन वेस्ट, बिकॉज देयर वाज एवरीथिंग वाज ऑफ वुड. सारा कुछ जल गया, सारे एसीज में से वो प्लास्टिक टपक रही थी, एवरीथिंग वॉज बर्न्ड. तो मैंने ये सोचा ओ गॉड, मुझे सारा मेरा इन्वेस्टमेंट चला गया, अब आई हैव टू लुक फॉर अ स्पेस, मुझे दूसरी जगह इमिडिएटली, क्योंकि कॉलिंग कभी रुकती नहीं है. दे कैन गिव यू वन डे टाइम, बट अगेन दे कांट इवन सिट एंड जस्ट सी देयर बिजनेस गोइंग डाउन. सो आई हैव टू क्विकली लुक फॉर अ स्पेस. मैंने नेक्स्ट डे मैंने जगह ढूंढी, वो भी एक टेम्प्रेरी जगह थी जहाँ पे सबको शिफ्ट किया गया. सो फिर काम शुरू हुआ. सो इन दिस केस अगर मैं डिप्रेशन में चली जाती कि मेरा तो बिजनेस ही वैसा खत्म हो गया, अब मैं क्या करूं. बट इसी के साथ जब मुझे लेटर मिला कि मेरा बिजनेस क्लोज होना है, अगेन आई वाज इन अ नेगेटिव मोड. व्हाई? बिकॉज माय थिंग्स वर क्लोज्ड, देयर वाज नो ऑप्शन फॉर मी टू स्टार्ट अगेन. अब मैं क्या करती? अगर मैं नेगेटिव एटीट्यूड रखती तो मैं आपके सामने यहाँ बैठी भी नहीं होती. आई वाज इन टोटल डिप्रेशन स्टेट. बट देन of course it took me some time to come out of it, I would be very honest in this, but then because of my positive attitude, because of my things which I feel ki nahi koi nahi ho jayega, kuch aur karenge, something else I'll do it, it's this is not the end of the world. So I was out from it and I started thinking ab main kya karu, what should I do now, what should I start now, ye main sochne lagi rather than अगर मैं उसी पे सोचती रहती कि ये क्या हो गया, मेरे साथ क्यों हुआ, मेरे साथ ही क्यों होना था, इन्होंने कैसे बंद कर दिया, दिस इज सो बैड, अब मैं क्या करूंगी, मेरे पैसे सारे चले गए, अब अगर मैं यही सब सोचती आई वुडन्ट हैव डन एनीथिंग. सो आपके पास लाइफ में बहुत कुछ ऐसे इंस्टेंसेस आएंगे. व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू ऑल दिस, बिकॉज यू आर सिटिंग अक्रॉस द फेंस एंड आई एम इन द फेंस राइट नाउ, आई हैव सीन ऑल दीस थिंग्स, सो आई कैन रियली टेल यू कि लुक, grass is always greener on the other side. It is not that bad scene out here. It's a good world. Come with a caution placard all the time, but then have a more positive mindset also, so that you can easily move ahead on a very good path without, of course, the bumps. You will face the bumps, but wo us, you know, us bump ki wo intensity nahi rahegi agar aap pehle se hi, you will be mentally prepared of all this, you know. So this is something very important. Uske baad then I thought of ab main kya karu ye karu ki kya karu, and then mere sath problem thi, I cannot leave Lucknow, I have to be here. So given those parameters, what else you can do? And since Lucknow is not like Mumbai or Delhi where you have so many options of to start a business, so here the options are very limited. Abhi bhi is aaj 2021 mein bhi, though we have a startup culture, but it is not like Mumbai or Delhi or Bangalore, right? So we need to accept this fact. So given parameters, hum kya kar sakte hain? So then I thought, let me have something. And then during these 11 years of my networking and all, you know, I got to know that there are many students who really aspirants of starting an enterprise, but they don't know really where to go, you know. They were looking always to Delhi or Bombay, Bangalore. They were going there, meeting people, then coming back. But yahan pe kuch aisa nahi tha. So I thought, let me have something here wherein I can share about this startups, about the policies, about the schemes, you know, how you can run a business. B, I can share my experiences which I have, because I have seen both the worlds, corporate world and entrepreneurship world. So the best person who can tell you whether you should go ahead with the business or not, how to go ahead, how to market your product, how to increase your sales, how to really promote yourself. So then I thought, let me start with this only. So I started interacting with startups. I started conducting meetups over here. Then I did various events wherein I called people from Bombay also over here, Delhi also. So that's how things started. So this consultancy thing really gave me a good, you know, I really enjoy doing this. So that's how, you know, you should And then, you know, it happens also when you start your business, when you are just raw, you know, you really want to focus yourself into one thing, correct? For me, at this age, at this point of age, I now don't want to start anything. I just want to guide people, consult people, and do whatever I really enjoy doing it. But when I was, you know, when I started a business, I could never even afford to do this because I have to earn money. I have to really do because I have left my job. So I have to, you know, I have to give example to my family also. Because they will say, ki, yari, kyun job choda? You know, so many, in fact, huh, yeah, I will tell you one more thing. When I left my job, my parents were dead against it. So I told my mom, Mom, let me do this business for a year or 2 years. Agar mera nahi chala, to I'll leave it and I'll join job. So she said, yeah, yeah, theek hai. I think on this pretext, she gave me yes to start my own business. But that never happened because I never I was never back to job again. So, but yes, I really, sometimes I really thought, I think that I should have gone again. But now then I'm okay with it, whatever I'm doing. Because this is my life, which I've chosen, and I'm responsible for it, whether it is good or bad. But I don't call it bad. It is a mix of good and bad. Because, you know, there are times when I was really successful. I was so happy. I was top of the world. But there's a certain time when I was actually down. I was feeling so low. So it happens in life. This is life, you know. But if you have really, if you have time, if you have perseverance, and if you think that I can do this hard work and I'm determined to do this, then of course you should go ahead with this. But then again, coming back to the same thing, that you need to identify your strengths first, you need to work on it, and then choose whatever you want to do. Because, you know, and then your idea should be good also. There are so many ideas, not every idea is successful. So you need to validate yourself. You are from Mumbai. There's so many mentors out there. You can reach out to them. Reach out to me as well. I can tell you whether this idea is good or bad. Because that is a validation one needs to, you need to have that, no? So once it is validated that, okay, you can do that, then comes how will you do that? Whether you have money or not. So from now comes the money thing. So where will you get the money? I had my savings, so I used that. How will you do it? Whether it's a bootstrap business wherein you're putting in your own money, your friend's money, your family money, or you are taking loan from bank and then you are doing it, whatever it is, that is your call you need to take upon. But then best is you need to bootstrap your business. You know, jab aapka paisa kisi cheez mein lagta hai, then you feel the pinch when the money is wasted. So it is better that you start your business from your own money. And उसके लिए आप जॉब कर सकते हो, save कर सकते हो पैसा, and then you can invest in your business. Best rate, because this is the thing, जब आप bootstrap करोगे तभी you can feel the pinch of money. And what I feel, when you start a business, it should be on a lean side, you know. Don't invest too much of money in infrastructure, team and all. It should be, the focus should be how to get revenue. You should have, because when you're starting your business, you are CEO, you are manager, you are peon even, you are accountant as well. You don't need to have so many people in your team unless until you have reached to a certain point. Have very minimal staff. The things which you think you cannot do, collaborate. Social media, you can, there are so many freelancers out here. Go to Fiverr and all, you can get freelancers over there. Involve with them. Focus on work from home job. You don't have to have an infrastructure. Why even a co-working? Start work from your home. So these things should be very important when you start a business. And focus should be on money-making things. Because normally what happens, you know, when startups start their enterprises, they have very lavish office, or even they take so many seats in a co-working space and all. Unless they're wasting money, but they, when they're not getting any revenue out of it, then they feel, arey, mera to paisa bekar ho gaya. So again, they chhod denge, ghar se kaam karenge. So it's better ki aap pehle se hi apne ko पहले से ही लीन उसमें लेके चलो कि मुझे बहुत ही कहते नहीं टाइट मैनेजमेंट लेके चलना है, कॉस्ट मैनेजमेंट लेके हमें चलना है, सो दैट आई डोंट वेस्ट मनी ऑन एनी अदर थिंग्स एक्सेप्ट माय बिजनेस, हाउ टू गेट सेल्स फ्रॉम माय बिजनेस, दैट शुड बी द फोकस ऑफ योर एंटरप्राइज. अगर इस तरह से आप लेके चलते हो, हर चीज आपने इवेल्युएट कर ली है, तो आई एम श्योर फिर तो स्काई इज द लिमिट कभी भी. बिकॉज there are people who are doing extremely good. See, they management karke business start kiya and they're really doing good. Even they don't have any family background, still they are doing good. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि नहीं होता है, होता है, बट देन इट्स बेटर टू बी कॉशियस बिफोर, बिकॉज आपको पता है कि क्या क्या चीजें प्रॉब्लम्स हम फेस कर सकते हैं, हमें पैसे रेडिली अवेलेबल अवेयर रहना पड़ेगा चीजों के लिए, और मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग मनी भी है, सब कुछ है, अगर आप में पॉजिटिव एटीट्यूड नहीं है तो आपका बिजनेस नहीं चल पाएगा. सो यू नो दीज थिंग्स, दिस इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ थिंग्स, यू नो दिस टेकिंग एबिलिटी हो गया, पॉजिटिव हो गया, परसिवरेंस हो गया, ये सब एक मिक्स हाइब्रिड मॉडल है पूरा, ये सब चीजें अगर आप में हैं, आई थिंक नथिंग विल स्टॉप यू. सो दीज ऑल थिंग, एंड आई थिंक ऑल्सो अगर आपको इफ यू एंड देन on now on OTT platform there are so many movies which are coming jisme startup ke bare mein hota hai, kaise startup journey start kari. I still see these movies, you know, kahin na kahin motivate to insaan hota hi hai, so you should watch these movies as well. Bahut hi acha lagega aapko, kuch na kuch clarity milegi usme, aapke team ke log hain unke sath baith ke movie dekho, so it's really good. Kahin na kahin, you know, even if you get 3% 4% of motivation from that movie, I think that's worth enough. And even when I'm talking, even if you're getting some, maybe 1% of motivation, if you're getting from my talk, thank you, I'm blessed in that case. So I watch good movies, they're coming, startup movies bahut sari hain OTT pe, you can go social network, I think Godfather, Rocket Singh, then bahut sari movies hain, some I'm not remembering those names, but you should watch those movies as well. So I think I have got few lines for you. Let me just read. I've got taken from Google itself. So yeah, just a moment. I just, okay. Now these lines are like, and this is, please listen carefully. ये हमें अपनी life में, you know, use करना पड़ेगा और कर रहे भी हैं. हम तो बहुत use कर रहे हैं. So you should just pay attention to these lines. It goes like this: when things go wrong, as they sometimes will. When the road you are trudging seems all uphill, when the funds are low and debts are high, this is also, it happens. And you want to smile, but you have to sigh, you know. When care is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but never quit. So these are things which is, I think, ye to mera ek anthem hai meri life ka. One should never quit because this is my life. I have chosen this life. And I want to have a good ride, though bumpy, but it will be a good ride. So this is my world, and I'm proud to be an entrepreneur. And also, during this pandemic, I think jaise kafi log ke businesses they were really, people lost their businesses, ya nahi chale, shops were closed down, businesses shut down. So what I did, I also thought ki ab kya kare, because I'm actually after this consulting, during this consulting period, I started working with women entrepreneurs. You know. Although I was helping startups, all male, female, but then slowly I just started focusing on just women entrepreneurs. So now I conduct workshops for them, help them, and all these things I do. So during these process only, I thought, now this is the best time. Jahan main apna, what I thought of, I dreamt of, I can do that. So you know, I started this magazine, Women Shine. Again, it's for women, but yes, it's for family, and the name says women shine, right? Because women always shine. So I started this, and by God's grace, now we are 14. Tomorrow we are launching a 14th edition of Women Shine, and it's really doing wonders. You must visit womenshine.in and see the amazing cover stories we have. The first cover story was of Sairi Chahal, because Sairi is actually, I really idolize her. I always see what she Rose is doing, everything. Sairi was there, Shelly Chopra, She the People, she was there. Then couple of celebrities, even Pooja Bedi, Rasika Duggal, Malika Sarabhai, Shobhna Narayan, all these people were there in my this cover pages. And tomorrow we have 14th edition wherein we are featuring Lilit Dubey as on the cover page. So but the God's Grace is doing well, though if you talk about, I'm not getting much revenue out of it, but then because of my perseverance, determination, hard work, and of positive attitude, I'm able to sail slowly and in a very good manner. I'm really because in this pandemic time, nobody will give you money because they're already on negative side, right? But then I am slowly getting something on this. But then this was my passion, which I really wanted to do. And I'm happy that we have finished 1 year and now looking for, and I've got around 9,000 subscribers as well. So I'm very happy with this magazine as well. Good. So for this two lines for everybody, that you should put your heart, mind, and soul, even in your smallest things, you know, smallest act of your business. I think that is the secret of success, because if you don't put your heart, mind, and soul, nothing will work out. So thank you so much. Hope I'm able to really motivate few people to start their businesses or maybe change their minds if they really want to. So all the best, everybody. And thank you for the opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, ma'am.
So, before you say thank you, I would like to say something, you know.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, you have done so much for Women Shine. Raj.
Yes, sir.
You and me, let's start Man Shine. You know, there's nothing for men. This is after hearing the entire talk, I feel really we should do something for the men.
Yes,
you
sir.
Ma'am, start kar rahe hain, ma'am. You know,
isme Man Shine. I have started for children as well. The section for the like from this month and July month, I'm launching Unbox Talent for children, kids, and then there's one section which is called this. और हिंदी लाइक यू नो हिंदी स्टोरीज हिंदी ऑल दीज थिंग्स तो मेन मेल को छोड़ के बाकी सारे एस्पेक्ट्स यू नो विमेन भी है फैमिली बच्चे भी है ग्रैंडीज भी है एवरीबॉडी इज देयर इन दिस
राज आर यू मी एंड यू एंड मी बी फीलिंग लेफ्ट आउट
दैट्स द पर्पस ऑफ डूइंग दिस
राज देयर आर फ्यू क्वेश्चंस ऑन द चैट बॉक्स
If participants want, they can unmute themselves and ask the question to ma'am.
Can I go ahead? Can I?
Yes, please.
Thank you. Ma'am, that was really inspiring. This is Milind from Goa. I would like to ask, in your opinion, how powerful or how influential is an organization such as BNI, for an example? Can we survive without such organizations, or you believe that it is mandatory to have some kind of a networking like that? Thank
Milind,
you.
Milind, I think it's, I'm surviving without BNI also, because in my city, we have BNI, we have And then in the beginning, I also mentioned that if your pocket allows, you can join membership of these organizations, because ultimately these are networking organizations. And even if you can afford that membership fees, why not? Because this will give you some result definitely. But if you cannot afford, then there's no point pressurizing yourself to join this association. So, and networking always helps. I also said, I mentioned that it may be not today. If you think that, If you are thinking of a quick things, no quick business, then don't join any networking organization. But if you think you want to build up networking, build up relationship with people, then you must join it. Because ek din mein business nahi hota hai. You never know. Ho bhi sakta hai, aisi baat nahi hai. But chances are very rare ki ekdam se business mil jaye. But yes, depending upon what work which you are doing, if you are from that sector and you have people in BNI of that sectors only. You may get money, of course, orders. But depending upon your pocket, if the membership, you can afford that, you must join it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Ma'am, we have one more question in our chat box from Neha Pagar. She asks, ma'am, how was your experience as a woman entrepreneur? How society treats you?
See, society is a very, you know, vague word. Society involves so many people. In my case, if you talk about myself as an individual, when I was going out and doing cold calls, right? When I was going visiting government departments, I didn't have a good experience over there. Because see, my kind of person cannot wait for hours outside the office and waiting for a principal secretary or minister to come to give me a time. Although the time was there, I'm there before time. And if I'm asked to sit for 3-4 hours, then I quickly just walk away from there. I don't go there. So I stopped going to government departments for my work because I didn't have any good experience over there. They don't even give your time. Even if they give time, they don't talk to you properly. So I think because they think agar koi female aapke office mein aayi hai, to aise hi hai types, you know, ye thinking hoti hai. So I'm not I'm not labeling anybody like that, but then एक ये feeling जो मैंने feel करी थी. So मैंने एक government department में जाना बंद कर दिया था. Then I thought, let me just focus on private sector instead of going to a government sector. So this was my first experience. Otherwise, society से मुझे कोई मतलब नहीं है. अगर मुझे कोई काम करना है, मुझे आगे जाना है, तो मैं because society तो आपको पीछे खींचेगी ना. Society क्या? Even if your family, right? अगर आपकी family आपको नहीं चाहती है कि आप काम करो, और अगर आप काम करने निकलते हो तो आप काम करोगे. अगर उनके उससे अपने घर में रहना शुरू कर दिया तो क्या हुआ? खत्म. तो इफ यू रियली वांट टू परस्यू योर ड्रीम्स एंड पैशन अबाउट, इफ यू हैव पैशन अबाउट समथिंग, यू नीड टू ब्रेक द रूल्स. आपको बढ़ना ही पड़ेगा आगे, अदरवाइज तो कुछ भी नहीं हो सकता. तो सोसाइटी का ट्रीटमेंट हम पे भी बहुत कुछ डिपेंड करता है कि हाउ आई अलाउ देम टू ट्रीट माई सेल्फ. तो एज फार एज माई इन माई केस, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी. मुझे कोई किसी से प्रॉब्लम नहीं होती है. इवन मैं बताना चाहूंगी, इवन आज के दिन में भी इन माय फैमिली, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे इवन बहुत ज्यादा उन्हें ये भी नहीं पता कि मैं करती क्या हूँ. बिकॉज यू नो दिस कंसल्टिंग थिंग, दीज पीपल, यू नो माय डैड इज फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट बैकग्राउंड, तो उनके गवर्नमेंट थिंकिंग वही है, एयरफोर्स, आर्मी, इंजीनियर, आईएएस, करेक्ट. दे डोंट थिंक कि आप कर क्या रहे हो, वेदर दिस इज गुड और नॉट, क्या है ये, क्या कंसल्टिंग क्या है, ऑल दीज थिंग्स. बट स्टिल मेरे को तो कुछ नहीं फर्क पड़ा अभी तक. आई एम हैप्पी विद आई एम गोइंग. तो आई टेल देम कि आप पापा समझोगे नहीं, कोई बात नहीं, मैं तो ये करूंगी जो मुझे करना है. सो यू नीड टू बी रियली ब्लंट समटाइम्स, एंड अगर आपको करना है तो गो अहेड एंड डू इट, डोंट केयर अबाउट सोसाइटी. दिस इज व्हाट आई फील.
मैम, वी आल्सो हैव अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम गौरव गुप्ता. ही आस्क्ड, मैम, हाउ डिड यू मैनेज फैमिली एक्सपेंसेस ड्यूरिंग दीज अप्स एंड डाउन्स?
या See, when I was working, when I was working, when I left my job, and usme kya hota, when I left my job, I had few savings. So, kuch to maine franchise mein kar diya tha. Kuch ke I had invested in various mutual funds and all, right? Even during my business as well, whenever I used to get a good paycheck, good order, kuch money I used to put in my business, some money I used to invest in mutual funds. Because I don't believe in FD and RD, recurring deposit. So, I invested in mutual funds. So when these kind of things happened, I sold off my mutual funds, and that gave me good amount, because itne saal se mutual fund unit accumulate hoti ja rahi thi, so it was a good amount. So I think you need to be exact, and I think this is a very good question, because aapko, when you are entering into a business, and aajkal ke time, because no one had ever thought ki ye bhi hoga, right? So similarly, I think this gives a very good example for us, that we need to be fully financially prepared for any kind of eventuality which can happen maybe after 2 years or 3 years or 4 years, correct? So ab aap business agar start bhi karte ho, you know there's a book jisme likha hai ki jo bhi aap business karo, jo bhi aapko revenue mile, salary mile, invest 1/10 of that amount into something, and that 1/10 of amount every month will add up to your, you know, amount something, wherein jab ko kuch emergency ho, you can use that fund. So I think it is very important for a startup to invest your money, take out some money. Agar aap 1/10 bhi nahi kar pate ho, 1/5 kuch bhi amount, kuch percentage aap nikal lo apne business se, jo ki aap apne is fund mein dalte ho, emergency fund bana lo uska, usme dalna shuru karo, because you never know ki kya hoga aage. Even I don't know ki kal kya hoga, maybe ek mahine baad kya scene hoga, you never know that. So you need, one needs to be very practical about it, and start thinking on investing money as well. So financial management bhi aapko bahut acha karna padega along your, ab wo time nahi reh gaya na ki chalo 2 saal baad hum isme mutual fund mein laga denge. Up day one se, the day you start your business, usi din se aap investment shuru kar do. This will really help you for such kind of things. I think this has helped me, because I invested in mutual funds, and from there I got good support, in fact, yes. And then my office was at home. Mere office expenses chale gaye the, mujhe kahin jana nahi tha, mera convince nahi lagta tha, main ghar se hi kaam karti thi. So this is also I also saved money on this as well, no? Otherwise aapko office expenses hota hai, rent dena hota hai, salaries deni hoti hain. Then my kind of work, I don't have a team, all are work from home, they're all freelancers who work with me. So ek do full time hoke, otherwise the rest is freelancers with me. So mera ek salary ka bhi tension nahi tha mujhe. So that's how I was able to sell properly during pandemic.
Ma'am, one last question from participant Suvarna Sularkar. Being a woman, sometimes the failure becomes more of an emotional breakdown. Have you had such an episode? And how did you deal with it?
I did. I'm also a human being, you know, after all. I faced all these things. The day I got this letter that my call center will be closed. You know, when you are getting paychecks of, my turnover was around 3 crores that point of time. And then suddenly when this thing happened, I was totally into a emotional breakdown, of course. But then thanks to my nature, my attitude, that really helped me. Because I'm a Leo by Zodiac. So uske bhi kuch genes aate hain aapke mein, you're in your attitude. So that helped me. And of course, my positive attitude, because I look positive things in every worst and bad things which happened with me. Even I'll just share one example with you. Not about emotional breakdown, but about the positive mindset and looking out, taking out positive thing in a bad sense. Things. This when this pandemic happened in April month, my dad was very sick. You know, he had corona. He had major lung infection. He was admitted. He was in ICU for 15-20 days. He had, you know, we had actually lost him. That was the case. But when, and in my case, because I am very close to my dad, I live with my dad only. So, you know what happened? Thinking of, arey kya ho gaya, ab kya hoga, kuch ho gaya, to kya hoga? I never thought all this. Maine ye socha ki kya kya cheeze kari jaye ki ye improvement hota jaye. We changed the hospital. We were totally doctor se kya ho raha hai, kya nahi ho raha hai, medicines. I was focusing on that because I wanted him to survive. Agar hum sochte hain ki are ab kya hoga, papa ko ye ho gaya, kya hoga, bhagwan ye sab karte rahe to kuch nahi hota. Though of course I prayed daily, I used to pray, but then I had this positive thing andar se. I had this he will survive, he will survive. Agar hum ye sochte rahe, and my mom was very, she was so upset, and unka BP bahut hi, we had major chaos at home. But then not even for one second I was very upset. I had very major emotional thing happened. No, nothing happened with me because I'm so strong from inside. I thought kya kaise kya kiya jaye, mom ghar mein mother ko aapko unko motivation dena hai, correct? So ye sab hote hi hote, because I'm that kind of person. Therefore I'm saying ki one should be, kuch bhi ho jaye, worse se worse ho jaye, you should, theek hai emotional breakdown thodi der ke liye hoga, but that should not continue forever, for long. You should be positive, come out of it, think of something else and go ahead and do it. Ye hota hai. So I have also faced so many things, ups and downs. Mere to, you know, I have a graph like that only. So it's okay. I'm okay with that graph.
Ma'am, I really agree with that point. Having a gut voice is really important these days. You know, and most of the time in the hard situations, when you're dealing with so much stuff, having that inner voice, ki nahi, will do it, yeah. Or like will come out with bright colors. So that is really important.
And you know, I used to tell my dad, jab wo unconscious bhi hote the, main kehti thi, papa, boli, I'm fine, you know, and he used to say, I'm fine. Hum unko le ja rahe the hospital. There was very less oxygen in him. We were taking him to hospital to get admitted, and raste bhar I started talking to him so that unki khatam na ho jaye breath, right? Because yes. When you talk, wo aap bhool jaoge ki haan, meko breath oxygen nahi aa raha hai. And maine bola, aap Gayatri mantra padho, aap ye padho, papa I am fine, you say this, say this. And he was telling me, okay, I am fine. Karte karte unko hospital leke aaya, you know. So that's how, that's if you have that spirit in you, you can apply anywhere.
A lot of help, ma'am.
Ma'am, I really appreciate in this current situation, the women's and...
Yeah, go on, sir. Shreya? Okay.
I have shared my LinkedIn ID also over here. So if anybody wants to connect with me, you can just send me a friend request. Or if I don't reply, you can message me also, that I can accept it.
Surely, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Send you my friend request on LinkedIn.
Ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Being a successful woman entrepreneur, and as you have said, you are attached to family, your dad. So, how did you manage your business and the family?
Yeah, I have got a very good family support. You know, when I was working, I have my two sons, right, 22 and 21 years old. So when I was working, they were very small. So my mother used to take care of them, and I used to work, right. So I have very good support at home. It's not that I have to take care of everything at home, then work, because I don't even enjoy doing all these work at home. So thankfully, aisa system ban gaya ki I have a help at home. Now we have a cook also. So there was never any problem. But yes, like maybe some when my children were not well and all, then I used to take leave. And then when I started my job, tak tak thode bade ho gaye the wo. But during my business journey, 2008 tak they were good enough. Tab I was able to manage them. But when they were very young, my mom and we had support at house where they were able to look after children. So that part was not a problem for me. So I had my total focus in my job or in my work or in my business. It was every time it was like that only. Even when I was traveling, I never had to ki kaun dekhega, kya dekhega, you know. So my parents were there to look after them. So that ways, the good support system I have. And thanks to God for that. Otherwise, bahut hi difficult hota mere liye. I can not even imagine things like that. But yes, it was a good support system I have. And then you told me, successful. I'm not successful. You know, there's a very different definition of successful. It is not that meri journey bhi khatam nahi hui hai, abhi aur bhi hai. So, you know, I have very small milestone where I feel I'm successful. Sometimes I'm not, sometimes I am. So, and then even in your case, if you want to start a business, there is no measurement of a success, you know. Agar aapki aaj deal, aap ek koi call pe gaye ho, aapki deal close ho gayi hai, that is success. आपका बिजनेस आपको पेचेक आपका बिजनेस का ऑर्डर का पेमेंट आपको मिल गया दैट इज सक्सेस फॉर यू आपका पैसा लॉस हो गया दैट्स अ लॉस इन योर बिजनेस सो सक्सेसफुल आई डोंट थिंक ऐसा कुछ नहीं है बट यस देयर आर सर्टेन माइलस्टोन्स व्हिच आई एम एबल टू अचीव व्हिच आई एम नॉट सम सर्टेन माइलस्टोन्स व्हिच आई एम नॉट एबल टू अचीव सो दैट्स इट
थैंक्स अ लॉट मैम it was very enlightening and admirable session. We really enjoyed it, ma'am. On behalf of IEEE Bombay session and entire organizing team, present this heartfelt gratitude to Aparna Mishra ma'am for her valuable time and presence during IEEE Entrepreneurship Bootcamp. Thank you so much, ma'am, for uplifting the event with your presence.
Even I enjoyed, though I was not able to see the faces, but still I enjoyed. Thank you so much, Raj and Shreya, and thank you so much, Mr. Dinesh. I think it was really good having me over, and even I enjoyed. And you know, whenever I talk, this is all from my heart which comes. You know, I never plan anything. It was just at random. I really talk because I enjoy talking to students on this very subject, which is very close to my heart because I've seen it. I'm living it. So it's really good to discuss things with you all. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, congratulations for the magazine, which is going to be released tomorrow.
Thank you. And you must, guys, you must really visit womenshine.in, see the magazine, read the editions. And of course, you can subscribe, which is for free. So please go ahead and click it. And you can join on Instagram as well. It is @womenshinemag. And I'm also got Instagram, which is I am Aparna Mishra, M with alphabet M only. So you can join me there as well.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.